Once I met this guy, I was hanging out with Puff Daddy, of all people.
Okay.
And this guy that was mates with Puff Daddy, he was called Tracy. He was pretty cool. And he used this metaphor, which I've not used in the book, and I realise now that perhaps I should have done. He goes, life's like a computer game. You get trapped on different levels, and until you can master that level, you'll be trapped on it. He goes, you obviously was trapped on the drug level, then you get trapped on the sex level. You've got to transcend these different levels. Now, for me, these levels are overseen, or you're helped ferried across by mentors. When I was a drug addict, I met Chip Summers. Chip Summers was the first person I met that was clean. He was a worse drug addict than I'd been. He had been in prison for armed robbery and stuff. I was never served a custodial sentence. So when I heard this guy talking about I don't take drugs anymore, even though there were lots of things that are different, he's an atheist, I'm not an atheist, I was able to sort of somehow download from him, or he were able to transfer to me, like any good teacher will, something that was latent within me but I was not in a position to realise. So he was the first mentor that I had. I made the decision, this is like, at first I didn't know it was possible. Like you say, you can't be what you can't see. I didn't know it was possible to not be a drug addict. I thought that was the solution. Then I saw people not being a drug addict, and then I was willing to do what he said, in this case 12-step recovery, which I believe is a good solution for anyone with addiction issues, or anyone that wants to change themselves actually. Then then I got kind of caught up on other stuff, the sexual behaviour, the obsession with fame, pleasure, individualism. And then I met a series of different mentors, including spiritual, devoted spiritual people, such as Radhanath Swami, who we both know, Amma, the great Indian saint. And then people that are more, what do I want to say, parochial, like my mentor, Jimmy, who's like a very successful producer and manager of a production company, who's got 4 kids, been married a long time, doesn't drink or take drugs like me, hasn't for longer than I have, who's quite a solid person from a background I identify with, who's intelligent and lucid. So I watch this person, and it was very practical mentorship. It's like, if I'm at the point of a decision, like, I'm gonna do this, Jimmy, I'm thinking of doing this, do not do this. I do what he says instead. So I'm already on a different path now. I'm using a consciousness that is not my own. I'm accessing external consciousness. So in a way, I know it's bloody simple, it's just following advice, but we don't have, we come from similar worlds, similar backgrounds. We don't have mentor traditions in bloody Essex or Wood Green. No one says, right, emulate this guy, this person is connected. You have to find them by chance and by circumstance, and sometimes you don't even know that that's what you need. So through my life, once I was switched onto it, because of the good fortune of being a drug addict, I became more alert to the possibility of doing it. So I started to look at, I like this guy, I want to emulate him. It could be like a comedian, like Bill Hicks, who's sadly already dead by the time I'd become a comedian. I thought, I like how he does that, and I model myself on that man, and what does he do? Of course, when you're constructing your identity, everything is about trying to connect to your own essence. Mm-hmm. So you're not gonna, I'm not from Texas, I'm not, I don't use anger in the same way as he does. I mean, there's all sorts of distinctions, I a little bit of Kenneth Williams, a little bit of Richard Pryor, a little bit of Peter Cook. You just copy the people that you admire, and it helps you to become yourself, because the latent energies within you will be realized if you have the external coordinates to follow. But don't get obsessed or fetishize the external coordinates, in which case you're just mimicking and you won't engage your own essence.